from India. It's a gift cover for a rumal. It's depicting Krishna and Radha enthroned in the center. It's made out of cotton and silk, but as you can see, warriors and hunters encircle it. And this particular hunter over here is on horseback, and he is embroidered hunting a lion. There he is. This is an Indian hunting scene depicting a prince and a princess on horseback. It's from northern India. It's from the 18th century, and it's a watercolor. It's watercolor and gold. It's on paper. How great is this? This is a board game with pegs and holes, and it's from Lebanon, perhaps Tyre. It's from the Middle Bronze Age, about 2000 to 1500 BC. It's made out of limestone, and it was popular from Egypt to Iran. And you had to throw the dice to move the pieces. The figures that are closest to us are the horse heads, and the figures who are farthest from us are the hound's head. So one person would play the other in a board game. A 4,000-year-old board game. Imagine that, with horses. I thought for fun I'd just shoot you a view of the mummies, because nobody ever wants to go to the Museum of Fine Arts and not see the mummies. Here's one right here. And the canopic jars of a human head, a baboon head, a hawk head, where it's the hawk, and a jackal, and those hold the vital organs of the deceased, but no horse, sorry, but they're pretty cool. And I thought,
I would hope so.
I'd give you one more mummy shot. Because that kind of person I am, thoughtful like that. This is a helmet from Iran or Eastern Turkey, from 249 BC to about 224 AD. It's made out of brass, and although it has been also made out of fabric or leather. But again, aren't you glad that the helmets have changed?
This is from the Temple of Athena at Athos in Turkey. It's Heracles, and he's driving off a band of centaurs. They're half man and half horse. This is a frieze off the top of the temple. Half man, half horse. And it's carved in stone. It's beautiful.
These are both Roman pieces. The date's uncertain. It's around the 1st century A.D. They're both Aurora driving a chariot. This one is layered onyx cameo, and this one is sardonyx, also in a cameo, Aurora driving a chariot. That's some beautiful jewelry. And here's a case of wonderful, priceless Red Sox artifacts. That is a base from the 2007 World Series. And there is on the right, the bottom right, a baseball from 2004 American League Championship Series. Yep, World Champion Red Sox. This beautiful landscape scene is by Carl Dujarin. He's Dutch. It was painted around 1660. It is an oil on canvas, and it is called Horseman Watering His Horse. There we go, a little less glare from that side. Very beautiful. Very lovely. Okay, so in all these Rembrandt Van Rynes, there are no horses. Whole gallery, which is full of Rembrandts. not a single horse. Here, Dutch painter Gerard de Bourges in 1634 painted in oil this man on horseback. In this painting by Roland Jacobs Savory, East Flemish, he painted it in 1615. It is called Forest Scene with Hunters. It's a very beautiful landscape. The castle in the background. Let me see if I can show you the hunters. There they are. There were your hunters on horseback. Priceless, beautiful art. Painted in 1615. This painting is by Francois Boucher in 1767. It's called Return from Market. And it's a pretty thin excuse to give it to you, but it was so nice. But it's got a little donkey right there, see? So that's why you got it. But it's got those pastel colors that you see in that era so often. It's so representative. I had to give you that. It's beautiful. Victor Pierre Puget is a French painter. He painted this in about 1885. It's in oil. It is called Arabs on the March. And I think that's funny. And the reason I think that's funny is because, looky here, it is an Arab on an Arab. That's an Arabian horse. Isn't that nice? Very beautiful painting. Very lovely. I know this is Horse Quest, but I had to stick in a Winslow Homer. They're doing a whole little gallery just devoted to him this month. And he was my father's favorite author. This one is very famous. It's called The Fog Warning. In 1885, he painted this oil. And obviously, this fisherman has to come in with his catch. This whole gallery is full of Winslow Homer's work. Atypical Americana art. This is an oil painting done in about 1860 by Albert Bierstadt. He is an American artist, and it's called View from the Wind River Mountains in Wyoming. And the horses in this one are these Native Americans who are coming down the pass into this beautiful, beautiful valley scene. Wow, what a panoramic painting. And here are your horses in art in this oil painting. You almost fell into that painting, didn't you? It's very lush. It's very, very, very beautiful. It takes you right there. This painting is entitled simply Moonlight. It's an American artist named Washington Alston, and it was painted in 1819. It's very beautiful, and here are your horses. That's one horse and some people on the banks of this beautiful scene. Yes, it's beautiful. And this is sculpted out of marble. It's by Horatio Greenough, and he did it in 1847, and it is Castor and Pollux. It's, of course, sculpted to emulate the ancient Greek and Roman carvings that we've already seen. Very beautiful.